For Volusia County, the cleanup will pick up this weekend. Let's get you live to Lauren Korn in Daytona Beach, where several stores are damaged tonight. Lauren?
Yes, Matt. Here we are, the main beach access off of International Speedway, the sign, world's most famous beach. But look over here, talk about destruction. These are all the storefronts. And here are the stores, and here are the awnings, a couple of them. I mean, just the whole row here, terrible. And you're about to see, we spent the whole day going up and down throughout Daytona Beach and the surrounding areas at all the damage left behind from Hurricane Matthew. Take a look. Volusia County residents woke up Friday morning to this. Tangled sheet metal, roofs ripped off of homes, businesses, and trees snapped in half, decorating the streets, leaving debris behind for folks to clean up.
It's just with all the leaves and stuff, I just wanted to get it cleared up. It was starting to back up in the street and stuff, so as you can see, it's working.
You can see how hard it is for me to even walk in a straight line without getting blown back. The wind is so strong and it comes in gusts. Not only the wind, but the rain just pelting you. I mean, it actually hurts trying to walk through to the other side of the street. All while the ocean did its own damage, knocking about 60 feet off of Sunglo Pier. Strong winds and rain damaged boats and swallowed others at Seven Seas Marina and Boatyard. But the weather nor curfew stopped these surfers from catching some high waves.
It's awesome. It's really good.
Well, we just have all our friends kind of sitting there in the mainland, and you know, you're kind of making fun of them a little bit, so we had to have a story for him and to surf when nobody else could, and I don't know, it's totally worth it.
Well, now we're facing the street here. I just want to show you how dark it is. A lot of us still without power. You can see the only light around here besides our camera lights are the street lights down way down there close to mainland there. We were down at Daytona Beach Shores and Port Orange area all day today, and we just now took a drive over here to Daytona Beach, and it was just completely dark, and we were trying to move in and out because all over the road, basically, because of all the debris left behind, glass and things like that. There was a checkpoint almost, the police officers there checking to make sure that it was just the news crews going by, because it is still dangerous out here. We still have a curfew until 7 a.m. in the morning. It is dangerous for anybody out to be walking around, especially driving, because you don't know what you can come across. So it's kind of like a ghost town out here. Matt, Ginger.
All right, time for you to go home and get some rest. Lauren Korn, thank you.